إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله وسلم عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evil of our own selves and from our evil actions. Whoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. And whoever He guides, no one can. Whoever Allah guides, no one can misguide. And whoever He misguides, no one can guide. And I bear witness that no one is worthy of worship besides Allah, alone, without any partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam is His last and final messenger. Brothers and sisters, this worldly life, this dunya, with its pleasures, its delights, and its glitter, is just a test. And you all know this. Allah Jalla wa Ala created mankind and placed them on earth only to test them which of them is best in deeds. And from this test, the good will be known from the bad, and the bad will be known from the good. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, Inna ja'alna ma 'ala al-ardi zinatan laha linabluwahum ayyuhum ahsanu 'amala. We have indeed made whatever is on earth as an adornment for it, in order to test which of them is the best indeed. And he says, Jalla wa Ala, liyamiz Allahu al-khabitha min al-tayyib, so that Allah may distinguish the wicked from the good. And the servant in this life, he is tested with good and he is tested with bad. So Allah, He will test us with good, with wealth, with health, with increase in numbers of family or property. And He's also going to test us with bad, with evil, like sickness, like poverty, like losing somebody that we love, so on and so forth. Allah will test us with good and with evil. He says, Jalla wa Ala, وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And we will test you with evil and with good as a trial, and towards us you shall return. So when Allah Jalla wa Ala tests us with bad, with something bad, then it is required from us as believers that we be patient, that we be patient upon what Allah Jalla wa Ala has decreed for us. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَلَنَبُلْوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. That we will certainly test you with some fear and hunger and some loss of wealth, lives and crops, but give news to those who are patient. So if we're tested in something bad, we have to be patient. And if Allah tests us with something good, we have to be grateful towards Allah for these favors that He has given us. Allah Jalla wa Ala, the Prophet ﷺ, he said in an authentic hadith, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ السَّرَّاءُ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءُ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. He said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, amazing is the affair of the believer. Verily, all of his affair is good. If good touches him, and this is only for the believer, and this is only for the believer. If good befalls him, then he is thankful to Allah, and that is good for him. And if adversity, if hardship befalls him, then he is patient, and that is good for him. In both cases, if he is thankful, receiving good, he will receive the reward of those who are thankful. And if he is patient, he will receive the reward of those who are patient. And ash-shukr, that we are thankful to Allah, is built on three pillars. The first is that we thank Allah with our hearts, that we are grateful towards Allah with our hearts, meaning that in our hearts we recognize that all these blessings that we have are only from Allah Jalla wa Ala alone. Secondly, with the tongue. We thank Allah with the tongue, meaning that we praise Allah Jalla wa Ala for these blessings and that we speak about these blessings that Allah Jalla wa Ala has given us. And the third is that we thank Allah bil jawarih, that we thank Allah with our limbs, meaning that we use these blessings in the obedience of Allah, in what pleases Allah and not His disobedience. Brothers and sisters, I gave this little introduction because today I want to speak about a story. A story of three men who were tested and trialed by Allah with His blessings and favors, in order to see which of them in the end will be thankful to Allah and which of them will not be thankful. And there's many benefits to be taken from these stories, that were related to us by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And as Muslims, when we hear these stories that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has related to us, we must take heed of the multiple lessons in them, and we must benefit from these lessons. So this hadith starts, it's a hadith narrated by Abi Huraira, and it's reported in Al-Bukhari and Al-Muslim. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, إِنَّ ثَلَاثَةً فِي بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ أَبْرَصْ وَأَقْرَعْ وَأَعْمَى. That indeed there was three people amongst the sons of Israel. And sons of Israel mean the son of Yaqub. Bani Israel, the sons of the Prophet Yaqub. One, he was Abras, meaning that he had the skin disease of vitiligo. Vitiligo is when you have patches of your skin that lose the pigmentation of skin, you lose it. So it appears very white. One of them, he had this disease of the skin. The other one, he was Aqra, he was bald, bald-headed. He had no hair on his head. And the third, he was A'ma, he was blind. فَأَرَادَ اللَّهُ أَنْ يَبْتَلِيَهُمْ. So Allah Jalla wa'ala, He willed to test these three people. فَبَعَثَ إِلَيْهِمْ مَلَكَ. So Allah, He sent to them an angel. And obviously this angel didn't go upon the appearance of the angel, but he went to them upon the appearance of a man. فَأَتَى الْأَبْرَصُ. So he came to the one who had the vitiligo. فَقَالَ أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What is the thing that you love the most? فَقَالَ لَوْنٌ حَسَنٌ وَجِيلٌ حَسَنٌ وَيَذْهَبُ عَنِّي الَّذِي قَدْ قَدْرِنْيَا النَّاسِ. I wish to have beautiful color and beautiful skin, and that this disease that I have, which makes people feel disgust towards me, I want it to be removed. فَقَالَ. So the angel, he said, or the Prophet said, فَمَسَحَهُ. So the angel, he wiped over him. فَذَهَبَ عَنْهُ قَدَرُهُ. So his disease went away. Then he asked them. So his disease went away. وَأُعْتِيَ لَوْنًا حَسَنًا وَجِيدًا حَسَنًا. And he was given a beautiful color and he was given a beautiful skin. فَقَالَ فَأَيُّ الْمَالِ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. Then he asked them, what is the wealth that you love the most? فَقَالَ الْإِبَلْ. He said, me is camels. فَأُعْتِيَ نَاقَةً عُشَرًا. So he was given a camel that was advanced in pregnancy, that was 10 months pregnant. And this, for the Arabs, it was anfasul amwal. It was the most precious of wealth, because not only does he get a camel, but he gets a second camel because the camel is going to give birth to another camel. And when the camel gives birth to another camel, then the camel also gives its milk. So this is amongst the most precious of wealth for al-Arab, for the Arabs, and even for the people in that time. So he gave him naqatun ashara, naqa, a she camel that was 10 months pregnant. فَقَالَ بَارَكَ اللَّهُ لَكَ فِيهَا. And then he said, may Allah bless you in it. May Allah bless you in this camel. فَأَتَى الْأَقْرَى. Then the angel, he went to see the bald-headed man. And he said, أَيُّ شَيْءٍ أَحَبُّ إِلَيْكَ. What is the thing that you love the most? فقال شعر حسن, that I have some nice hair. ويذهب عني هذا الذي قذرني الناس, and that this what people feel disgust towards me because my baldness, that it goes away, that it's removed. فمسحه فذهب عنه ما كان عنده. يعني so the angel, he wiped on his body, and the disease that he had it went away. فأعطي شعرا حسنا, and he was given beautiful hair. Then the angel asked him the same thing, فأي شيء أحب إليك, what is the فأي مال أحب إليك, what is the wealth that you desire the most. He said البقر, I want a cow. فأعطي بقرة حاملا, and he was given a cow that was pregnant. Then he said بارك الله لك فيها, may Allah bless you in it. Then he came to الأعمى, he came to the one who was blind, and he asked him أي شيء أحب إليك, what is the thing that you love the most. فقال أن يرد الله إلي بصري, that Allah, he restores my eyesight. فأبصر به الناس, so that I may see people. قال, so the Prophet said, فمسحه, so he wiped over him. فرد الله إليه بصره, so then Allah, he restored his eyesight. Then he asked him, فأي المني أحب إليك, and what is the wealth that you love the most. قال الغنم, he said sheep. فأعطي شاة والدا, so he was given a sheep that was pregnant. فأنتج هذان وولد هذا, so what happened is the she camel, the cow, and the sheep, they all gave birth to their children, and all of a sudden those children and those camels, and they multiplied and multiplied and multiplied until the Prophet ﷺ, he informs us, فَكَانَ لِهَذَا وَادٍ مِنَ الْإِبِلِ, until the one who wanted the camels, he had a valley that was filled with camels. So this is the dua of the angel. May Allah bless you in it. So he was blessed with his camels until his camels, they filled the whole valley. وَلِهَذَا وَادٍ مِنَ الْبَقَرِ وَلِهَذَا وَادٍ مِنَ الْغَنَمِ, and for that one he had a whole valley filled with cows, and the other one he had a whole valley filled with ghanam, with sheep. Then the Prophet ﷺ, he said, ثُمَّ إِنَّهُ أَتَى الْأَبْرَصِ فِي صُورَتِهِ وَهَيْئَتِهِ, and then this is now when the test starts. Then the angel, he took the shape and the form of the one who had vitiligo, the one who had that skin of the disease, and he went to him with the appearance that he had before, and he told him, رجل مسكين, I'm a poor man, قد انقطعت بي الحبال في سفري, I have no more provisions, all my provisions have run out in my journey. فلا بلاغ لي اليوم إلا بالله ثم بك, and I will not be able to reach my destination if it's not for the help of Allah, then your help. He told them, أسألك, I asked you, بالذي أعطاك اللون الحسن والجيد الحسن والمال بعيرا, I asked you by the one who gave you this beautiful skin and this beautiful color and this wealth, that you just give me one camel. He had a valley filled with camels. He says, I just want one camel. أَتَبَلَّغُ عَلَيْهِ فِي السَّفَرِ, so that it may suffice me in my journey to reach my destination. Just one camel. And what did the man reply? He said, الْحُقُوا كَثِيرًا, he said, I have many obligations. I can't give you a camel. I have many obligations. I have to pay for this, I have to pay for that. He has a whole valley of camels, but because of his stinginess, he says what he says. I have too many obligations. So then the angel says, كَأَنِّي أَعْرِفُكَ, I know who you are. I recognize you. أَلَمْ تَكُنْ أَبْرَسْ يَقْذَرُكَ النَّاسِ. Weren't you abras? Didn't you have this disease of the skin? That people, they felt disgust when they saw you. فَقِيرًا فَأَعْطَاكَ اللَّهِ. And weren't you poor? And Allah gave you this wealth. And what did he reply? إِنَّمَا وَرِثْتُ هَذَا الْمَالِ كَابِرًا عَنْ كَابِرٍ. He said, I only inherited this wealth from my forefathers. So subhanAllah, his stinginess caused him to lie and caused him to deny the favors of Allah Jalla wa'ala upon him. And this is similar to what Allah Jalla wa'ala says in the Quran. وَإِذَا أَنْعَمْنَا عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ أَعْرَضَ وَنَآ بِجَانِبِهِ وَإِذَا مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ كَانَ يَوْسَى. That when we grant people our favors, they turn away. Meaning that they turn away from Allah and they turn away from thanking Allah from His shukr. And they distance themselves from His obedience and they become arrogant. And when evil touches them, they lose all hope. SubhanAllah. So this is not the behavior of the believer. The believer, when blessings are given to him, he humbles himself to Allah. And he is thankful to Allah for these blessings. And if he is afflicted with hardship, he supplicates Allah and has hope in Allah that Allah will remove this harm. And that Allah Jalla wa'ala will remove this harm. And this is a way for the test to be lighter upon the believer. And he says also Jalla wa'ala, لَا يَسْأَمُ الْإِنسَانُ مِنْ دُعَاءِ الْخَيْرِ وَإِنْ مَسَّهُ الشَّرُّ فَيَأُوسٌ قَنُوتٌ. People do not tire from seeking wealth. People don't tire from seeking wealth, from asking Allah wealth. They don't tire from that, from seeking the dunya. And if evil touches him, he is desperate and loses all hope. وَلَئِنْ أَذَقْنَاهُ رَحْمَةً مِنَّا مِنْ بَعْدِ ضَرَّاءَ مَسَّتْهُ لَيَقُولَنَّ هَذَا لِي. And if we let him taste a mercy from us after being touched with adversity, the story of this abras, of this one who was sick and he was poor, they will certainly say, this is mine, this is what I deserve. Like Mujahid said, هذا بعملي أنا محقوقون بهذا. That when Allah, he blesses them and gives them good, what do they say? It's because of my hard work. It's because of me. It's because of my intelligence, my hard work. I deserve this. They deny recognizing that this favor is from Allah. They reject that. So we need to be beware, brothers and sisters, that these are the characteristics that we should not embellish ourselves with or uglify ourselves with. Rather, these are the correct characteristics of those who disbelieve in Allah and in the day and the last day. So what did the angel reply to his ungratefulness and to his lies? What did he reply to him? What did he say to him? قَالَ إِن كُنْتَ كَاذِبًا. If you are a liar, فَصَيَّرَكَ اللَّهُ إِلَى مَكُنْتَ. May Allah turn you back to what you were. Meaning, going back to having the disease and being poor. Then he went to an aqra. He went to the bald man. Fi surati. And he went to him in his shape and in his form. And he asked him the same thing. I am a poor man. I've run out of my provisions. Help me reach my destination. And the aqra, he said exactly the same thing. The bald man, he said exactly the same thing. That deed, I have many obligations. And when he said, but I think I know you. I know you. I recognize you. You were that bald man who was poor. And he's going to say, what? He says, no. This wealth, I inherited it from my forefathers. So after that, who's left? The blind man is left. He is left to be tested. وَأَتَى الْأَعْمَى فِي صُورَتِهِ وَهَيْئَتِهِ. So the angel went to the blind man, the one who was previously blind, in his old form and shape, as a blind man, he went to him. فَقَالَ رَجُلٌ مِسْكِينٌ. I am a poor man. وابن السبيل, and I am a traveler. إن قطعت بي الحبال في سفري, that all the provisions that I had to complete my journey, they have all run out. فلا بلاغ لي اليوم إلا بالله ثم بي, and I will not be able to reach my destination if it's not for your help, for if it's not for the help of Allah, then your help. أسألك بالذي رد عليك بصرك, I ask you by the one who restored your eyesight. شاتن, just one sheep, أتبلغ بها في السفر, so that I may reach my destination, I may complete my journey. فقال, so this is what the A'ma says, this is what the A'ma, the blind man, he said, قد كنت أعمى, I was blind, فرد الله ولي بصري, and Allah, He restored my eyesight. فخذ ما شئت, take whatever you want, ودع ما شئت, and leave whatever you want, فوالله لا أجهدك اليوم شيئا أخذته لله, because by Allah, I will not stop you today from taking something that you take for Allah's sake. SubhanAllah, look at this blind man who has a shukr, not only in his heart, but also his tongue. He's expressing it, and also with his jawari, with his limbs, because he's giving this money, his wealth, to this man. Whatever this man wanted to take, the angel, he could have taken it. Why? Because he knows that his wealth, his money, his eyesight, everything that he has is from Allah alone. So the angel says, "Amsik malak, keep your wealth. Keep your wealth. Innama ibtulitum, indeed you were tested. Faqad rudiya ank, indeed Allah was pleased with you. Wa sukhita ala sahibik, and Allah jalla wa ala, He was angry against your two companions, against your two companions, meaning the aqra, the one who had the disease of the skin, and the one who was bald. So what we can benefit from this hadith, brothers and sisters, small benefits. First is that whoever is thankful to Allah, Allah Jalla wa'ala will be pleased with him. And this is what we seek as Muslims, that we seek Allah's pleasure. We seek that Allah is satisfied with us. Because if Allah is pleased with you and is satisfied with you, then the doors of Jannah will be wide open for you. And we see also in this hadith that if you're ungrateful towards Allah, Allah gives you blessings, and you don't recognize that these blessings are from Allah, that you do not use these blessings in the obedience of Allah, then you will earn Allah's anger. Also, we benefit from this hadith, whoever is shakir, whoever is grateful towards Allah for the blessings that He gave him, Allah Jalla wa'ala will make those blessings remain. They will stay with him. Rather, Allah Jalla wa'ala will increase those blessings, and He will put barakah, blessings, in those favors. He will put barakah, lots of khair, lots of good in those blessings. Allah Jalla wa'ala says, وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ وَلَإِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ. Your Lord has proclaimed that if you are thankful and grateful, I will increase your blessings and your favors. But if you are ungrateful, then indeed my punishment is severe. Also, brothers and sisters, what we can benefit from this hadith is fadlu sadaqah, the virtues of sadaqah, the virtues of charity, the virtues of having kindness and being gentle towards those who are weak, towards those who are poor, and also to strive in helping them reach their goals and also fulfill their needs. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا نسألك الجنة وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل, ونعوذ بك من النار وما قرب إليها من قول أو عمل. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وأقيم الصلاة